So hello and welcome everyone. Welcome to Creatrix channel. So first of all, let me introduce myself. My name is Vishal Soni and I have cleared engineering services examination 2 times from electronics and telecommunication branch, both times in double digit rank. In 2014, my rank was 98 and in 2015, my rank was 25th. I have served as a Group A Gazetted Officer in Indian Railways and in Indian Telecommunication Services. So most of you must have been following me on the Creatrix channel for electromagnetic field theory. So if you are a seeker of a free education, this is the channel for you. And you must understand that all these free initiatives is coming your way because of the Unacademy. So Unacademy is the revolution in the field of the free education and the affordable education. So how can you access those free courses? So if you want to access the free courses, you must immediately subscribe this channel, Creatrix channel, because all the top educators of the country is providing the free course on this channel. And that free course is absolutely brilliant in content, that is systematic, that is organized, and that is complete. So complete playlist you will be getting of a particular subject. You can develop the concept, you can gain confidence, more than that, you can love the subject. So immediately subscribe this channel. Secondly, if you want to access more free content, then you must immediately download the Unacademy Learners app, because on the Unacademy Learners app, top educators of the country are conducting the free special classes. In that free special classes, you can get topic wise clarity of a particular concept. And do not forget to follow me on the Unacademy learning app. So you can also access the courses. So you must have 2 things. First is your YouTube channel. This YouTube channel, Creatrix YouTube channel, must be subscribed. Secondly, you must understand that you should have the Unacademy learning app. That is must for you in order to crack the examination. So these are the parts of the free education. And if you want to organize your content well, if you want more comprehensive manner, if you want other advantages of the Unacademy, then what are the other initiatives that is running by the Unacademy? So another initiative that is running by the Unacademy is Unacademy Plus. So on the Unacademy Plus, this is very affordable for those who actually want to take their preparation to the next level. So aapko Unacademy Plus mein kya kya milega? You will be getting the live classes on a fixed time so that you can get more disciplined, you can get more organized, and you have something in your mind that at this particular time my classes are going to run. Apart from that, you will get free test series designed by the educator itself. So gone those times when we have lot of errors in the test series, we do not have the discussions of the test series. So there the test series will be conducted by the educators. They themselves will be discussing the solutions of that particular thing. So you can imagine that your preparation is going to the next level for this. Apart from that, those who have prepared themselves for the examination, so for them there are crash courses also available. Again, the crash courses will going to help you in achieve good ranks. Those who have already achieved good ranks and want to improve their rank, for them there are rank improvement batches. More than that, you can also see that there are unlimited practice sessions. So what do you understand by unlimited practice session? Which means there will be various doubt solving sessions. Apart from the doubt solving sessions, there are weekly quizzes, and with the help of those weekly quizzes, you can enhance your problem solving skills. So lot of unlimited doubt solving sessions, lot of quiz sessions, systematic content, structured content. You can download the PDF after the lectures, so you don't have to waste your time in order to making notes. You can utilize those times to practice the particular concepts, or you can use those times to just write down the formulas so that you can remember those formulas quickly. Apart from this plus subscription, there is also one subscription which is known as Iconic. So Iconic subscriptions are for them who actually do not have the self motivation but having the talent. So if they are having the talent and you do not have the self motivation that how can I push myself to crack the examination, so in this Iconic subscription you will be assigned a personal coach. So this personal coach is going to be with you every time, and he will help you to achieve your dreams. You will get a study planner which will be customized for you. You will get the expert guidelines who have already topped the examination. They will be basically hand holding you to crack the examination. So if you think you are not self motivated, if you think you do not have the proper background to crack any particular competitive examination, so this Iconic subscription is must for you. This is going to help you. So if you want the free education, then YouTube channel and the special classes are must for you. And if you can afford a little bit, how much you should afford, that we'll discuss in a while. But if you can afford a little bit, you should come onto this Unacademy Plus. And more than that, if you want the expedited process in your preparation, aap jaldi se exam nikalna chahte hain, jaldi se apni galtiyan sudharna chahte hain, so this Iconic subscription is for you. Then now let us start today's lecture, which is on the communication system. So now let us start the lecture.
Hello friends, welcome to this lecture of communication system. So in the last class, we studied about how to draw the output of a peak detector circuit. In this class, we will discuss that what are the effect of the time constraints is on the output waveform of a peak detector circuit. So first of all, let me consider the input of a peak detector circuit, that is x of t, as A sine omega naught t. So I can also write it as A of t sine omega naught t, where value of A of t is A. We know that A of t is always greater than 0. So the envelope of this particular signal x of t becomes A. From the diagram we can also understood this is the diagram of input signal x of t. This is the sinusoidal waveform. This value is A. We know that envelope is nothing but trace of positive peaks. So if I will trace the positive peaks, this is the first positive peak, this is the second, this is the third, and so on. So if I will trace all the positive peaks, so this will give us the envelope. So if I have to draw the diagram of envelope, so the diagram of envelope should look like a constant value of A for all the time, and this will represent the envelope. So these are the positive peaks. So from here we can note down that in order to detect envelope, it is mandatory to detect peaks, because if we cannot detect the positive peaks, then obviously we will not have a trace of positive peaks and envelope can never be drawn. So we have to detect positive peaks first of all. So this is the basic required to understand the effect of time constants on the output waveform. So let us understand the case one. In the case 1, I am talking about the charging time constant. So this is your charging time constant. What is the charging time constant? The charging time constant is RSC. And what is the charging equation of output? The charging equation is x of t 1 minus e to the power minus t by RSC. So now in this case I am assuming that this charging time constant RSC is high. Initially we used to assume that this TSC is low. So here I am discussing the different cases. So initially I am assuming this charging time constant to be high. If this charging time constant is high, so this y of t is equal to x of t 1 minus e to the power minus t by RSC. We know that exponential terms are always greater than 0, and if we will subtract something from 1 which is greater than 0, so from here you can conclude that this y of t will always be less than or equal to x of. So this is the conclusion in this case. Also, we can conclude from here that if charging time constant is very high, so the capacitor will charge slowly. So the capacitor will charge slowly and it will follow this particular exponential charging path. So it will follow exponential charging path. So let me draw the waveform. So first of all, I will draw the input. this is the input. A sine omega naught t. This is the trace of all the positive peaks, so it will be A. This is your input, x of t equal to A sine omega naught t, and these are the positive peaks, this one, this positive peaks, and this particular positive peak. So this is your input signal, and this is the variation of input sinusoidal signal. So the input sinusoidal signal varies in this particular form, and this is your t equal to 0. So let us discuss its operation. So to discuss the operation, I will start from t equal to 0. We know that at t equal to 0, the input x of t is 0, which means VAT will also be 0, and the whole circuitry will be discharge mode, so the output will also be 0, and the voltage across capacitor will be 0. What will happen at t equal to 0 plus? At t equal to 0 plus, this input signal is increasing in nature, so this x of t becomes greater than 0, which means VA of t becomes greater than 0. Since Yt represents the voltage across capacitor, and the voltage across capacitor does not allow sudden change of voltage, so it remains 0. And from here you can conclude that VAT is greater than VBT. Whenever VAT is greater than VBT, diode becomes forward bias, capacitor starts charging, and now Yt will follow this exponential charging path. So we know that from here, during this exponential charging path, the capacitor will charge very slowly, and the Yt will never be exactly equal to x of t, but it will be less than or equal to xt. So to draw the diagram of Yt, we know that from here the Yt will follow an exponential path, and it can never approximate the x of t. So this is the curve of Yt, and this is the curve of xt. So from here you can see that as the input is given, the capacitor is being charged very, very slowly. Now let us discuss the operation of the circuit at this particular t naught. What happens at this t naught? So at this particular instant, at t is equal to t naught, at this particular instance, this xt is having some value a naught, which is equal to va of t, has some value v naught, and output, which is voltage across the capacitor, is also v naught. But at t is equal to t naught plus, you can observe that the graph of input from here is downward in nature. So this x of t, which represents VA of t, will always be less than a naught. This is a naught. And Yt represents voltage across capacitor, so it does not allow sudden change of voltage, so it remains at a naught. So from here you can say that VA of t becomes less than VB of t, diode becomes reverse bias, and capacitor starts discharging. And while discharging, we know that it will follow exponential discharging path. So here this is the discharging path. From here onwards, the input will increase, the capacitor voltage will remain here, diode will again become forward bias, and capacitor will start charging. So while charging, it will not follow this input x of t, rather it will be charged by an exponential path, and that exponential path should always be less than the input. So it will again charge by following this exponential path. After that, it will be discharging and it will again follow this particular path. So from here, you can very clearly see that these are the positive peaks of the signal x of t. And whenever the charging time constant is very high, the output waveform, which is drawn here by using this black ink, is not able to detect the positive peaks of this input signal x of t. So you can very clearly from here say that whenever the charging time constant is very high, the positive peak detector circuit is not able to detect the positive peaks of the input. And if it is not detecting the positive peaks, it is almost impossible to extract the envelope of the signal. So what is the conclusion? The conclusion is whenever RSC is very small, almost tending to zero, in all that cases, YT becomes XT while charging, and YT detects all the positive peaks of XT. So this is highly desirable. Now, if charging time constant becomes large, then YT is less than or equal to XT while charging, and YT is not able to detect positive peaks of XT. So it is highly undesirable. So from the charging time constant point of view, we always need that the charging time constant should be as low as possible so that the output waveform can always detect the positive peaks of the circuit. Now in the case 2, let us discuss the effect of discharging time constant on output waveform. So while discussing this, I am assuming that this charging time constant we have assumed to be very low, so it is able to detect all the positive peaks. So this I am assuming, and we have to see the effect of discharging time constant RLC. So let us see what is the effect of this discharging time constants. Now let us discuss in the same way again. Assume that this x of t to be a sine omega naught t. This is the input signal x of t versus t, and this is the sinusoidal waveform. So this value will be a. All these points will represent the positive peaks, and the envelope of this particular signal will be constant value of a for all values of time. So this is the envelope. Now let us discuss the output of circuit when the circuit is discharging. So we know that the discharging curve equation has e to the power minus t minus t naught by RLC. So we have already discussed that as discharging time constant RLC increases, the output curve YT becomes more and more flatter. So if I have to draw the diagram of yt for different time constants is, so if td1 is greater than td2 is greater than td3, then the output waveforms will be y of t. This graph will start at t is equal to t naught. So for td1, it will be more flatter. For td2, it will be less flatter. And for td3, so in this way, you can observe that as the time constants is increasing, this curve is becoming more and more flatter. Or you can say that as the discharging time constant is decreasing, this curve is becoming more and more vertical. So as the time constant is increasing, it is approaching the slope 0. While the time constant is decreasing, it is approaching the slope plus minus infinity. So as the discharging time constant increases, the discharging curve or the yt tries to become more and more horizontal. Okay, so let me discuss different cases. So initially I am discussing this td of rlc to be sufficiently large, which means the capacitor takes sufficiently large time to discharge itself. It means the discharging curve will be almost horizontal. So let me draw the diagram. This is our input A sine omega naught t. These are the positive peaks, and this is the trace of positive peaks, which is A. This is your input signal x of t equal to A sine omega naught t. And I have to draw the output yt. So to draw the output yt, we know that we have initially assumed charging time constant to be very low. So while charging, it will charge up to the peak value. What about discharging? So we have assumed the discharging time constant to be sufficiently large, and now the capacitor will discharge very slowly and almost the curve will become horizontal. So this is the discharging curve. At this point, it again meet up. Now it will charge to this peak value of the input. So it charges to the peak value of input. After this point, it again discharges. And the discharging curve becomes almost horizontal. Again, once it intersects this x of t, so it will again charge to the peak value, and so on. So in this particular case, you can say that this is the discharging curve and this is the charging curve. Now let me draw the diagram of y of t separately. So this is your y of t. So let me draw the diagram of yt separately. This is the envelope of the input signal. So this is E of t equal to A. Now I am drawing the diagram of the yt. So first of all, it charges to this peak of A and it slowly discharges to some point this. Then it again charges to the peak value of A and slowly discharges to some other point. Then it again charges to this peak value of A, then it slowly discharges. So from here you can see that if this black curve represents y of t and this e of t represents the envelope, so you can say that whenever the discharging time constant RLC is sufficiently large, in all that cases the output y of t is nothing but it is the approximation of envelope, or y of t is tracking the envelope of x of t. So it is trying to track the envelope, and you can see that initially it is approaching this peak value A, then it is trying to track this value of A, and in between these gaps represents the tracking error. So from here you can see that if this discharging time constant is being increased, this tracking error will be lesser. So this is very important point, that if discharging time constant is very large or the capacitor is discharging very slowly, in all that cases yt is tracking the envelope of xt, and more will be the time constant, lesser will be the tracking error. Now let me discuss another case. In this case, I am taking this charging time constant RLC to be large. So in this case it is not sufficiently large, but it is large. So what will happen in this case? In this case, capacitor will discharge slowly and the discharging curve will be flatter. So it will not be almost horizontal, but it will be flatter. So let us try to draw the output in this particular case. So in this case, this is the input x of t, which is A sine omega naught t, and this is the trace of the positive peaks, so it is representing this value A. We had again assumed this charging time constant to be almost tending to zero. So initially the yt will charge to its peak value. Now the RLC is large but not sufficiently large, so the curve will be flatter but not exactly horizontal, so the curve will be slightly tilted. Then it will again charge to its peak value, then again curve will be slightly tilted, then again it will charge to its peak value. Now let me draw this y of t diagram separately. So if I will draw this y of t separately, this is the envelope e of t equal to e. So in this case what is happening, initially it is charging to its peak value of A, but not discharging is not that slow, but it is slower, so it will discharge up to this point, then again it will charge to this peak value. Discharging is slower in this case, so the curve will be flatter but not exactly horizontal. So in this case we have decreased the discharging time constant, and from there you can see that this curve y of t is also trying to track this envelope, but in this particular case this tracking error is large. So here you get larger tracking error. So what happens in these two cases? In the first case, RLC was sufficiently large. And in the second case, this RLC was, I have assumed, large, and this TD1 is greater than TD2. So from here, you can say that in both the cases, YT is giving the tracking approximation, or it is tracking the envelope of x of t. And if discharging time constant decreases, tracking error increases. So these two points are very important, that when discharging time constant is large enough, the curve will become more and more flat. And if the curve is more and more flat, then it will give a better approximation of the envelope. Now let us discuss another case in which I am assuming this discharging time constant RLC to be very, very small. So this is very small. So what will happen in this case? In this case, the capacitor will discharge quickly or rapidly. If the capacitor is discharging rapidly, then obviously the discharging curve will be less flatter, or it will tries to become vertical. So now let me draw the diagram in this case also. This is the input signal x of t equal to a sine omega naught t, this is t. Now I want to draw the output waveform yt. So we have already assumed that the charging time constant should be very much less than zero. So all the charging curves will charge to the peak value of input. So this is the trace of the positive peaks, and this is A. So while charging, it will charge to this peak value, which is A. Now while discharging, if you look closely, as the discharging time constant decreases, the curve becomes more and more vertical. So this was the first case, this was the second case. If I will further decrease the discharging time constant, so this curve will become more vertical. If I will further decrease the discharging time constant, this curve will become more vertical, and so on. So these are the different variations of discharging curve once the discharging time constant is decreased. So out of these, I am choosing this one, that while decreasing, it is following this particular path. So at this point, again, yt and xt meet up. So it will again charge up to its peak value. Then it will again discharge very quickly, or following this particular vertical path. Again, meetup is occurring. So it will charge to the peak value within no time, because the time constant is almost tending to zero. So it will exactly follow the input signal x of t. And again, while discharging, it will discharge very quickly, following almost vertical line. Now, what you can see from here that if I will draw the output waveform separately, so this is the envelope A and this is your sinusoidal signal A sine omega naught t. So what is happening in this case? Though it is detecting the positive peak of the envelope, but after detecting the positive peak, it is discharging very rapidly. So very clearly you can see that the tracking error is huge. It is again charging to its peak value and this again discharging quickly. So from here you can see that this is the envelope and this is the tracking of envelope. So in this case we also wanted to track this particular envelope, but what is happening, because this discharging time constant is very small, so this tracking error or this particular tracking error is very large. And if you will look closely, so instead of tracking the envelope, in this particular case the output waveform is tracking the carrier signal or the sinusoidal signal. So this is x of t, and if I will draw the output waveform y of t, so what it is doing, it is tracking this x of t. Here till now it is following it is as it is. Now if x of t is decreasing, so it is also trying to follow this signal x of t. Then again it tracks this signal perfectly from here. Then again while discharging it is tracking this signal sine omega naught t. So what happens in this case, this y of t becomes tracking of x of t. We were interested in tracking the envelope of x of t, but since discharging time constant is very small, that is why this tracking error becomes so large that it is not able to detect the envelope of x of t. Rather, it starts detecting this x of t, or it starts tracking this particular signal x of t. So you can see from here that y of t is giving the tracking of this signal x of t, and it is not tracking this particular envelope. So these two discussions are very much of importance, that whenever the discharging time constant RLC is sufficiently large, so in this particular case the output waveform Y of t of a peak detector circuit YT of peak detector circuit gives the tracking of envelope of x of t. Obviously there will be some tracking error, so this gives the tracking of envelope of x of t. Now if this RLC is very small, so in that case the YT of peak detector circuit does not give the tracking of envelope of XT, rather it starts tracking the signal itself. So it always gives the tracking of X of T, which is not of our interest, because we wanted to detect the envelope of the given signal or the positive peaks of the given signal. So YT curve gives the tracking of X of T. So we are not interested in tracking of X of T, rather we want to detect or we want to track the envelope of X of T. So what is the conclusion of all these three cases? Now, if I have a signal X of T and this is the peak detector circuit and this is your output YT. Now, if charging time constant is large, then Y of T is not able to detect peaks of XT. In the second case, this is peak detector circuit. In this case, I am tending this RSC to be very small or zero and RLC to be sufficiently large. So in this case, YT tracks the envelope of X of T and also YT is able to detect the peaks of XT. In the third case, this is the peak detector circuit. Here also I am choosing this RSC to be tending to zero, but this RLC is also small. So in this case, YT does not track the envelope of XT, rather it tracks the signal itself and since RSC is zero, so in this case, it will also able to detect the peaks of XT. So this is very important conclusion and this conclusion you must also relate that whenever charging time constant is large, output will not be able to detect the peaks. Whenever discharging time constant is very small, the output will always track X of T instead of tracking the envelope of X of T. We wanted to track the envelope of X of T. So out of these three cases, we will always prefer this particular arrangement in which the charging time constant is as small as possible and the discharging time constant should be sufficiently large so that we can detect the peak as well as we can detect the envelope of X of T rather detecting the X of T.
So if you have liked today's lecture and you want to subscribe to Unacademy Plus, the very first thing that you should understand that you should use this particular code. What is the code? The code is VishalGate. Write my name and attach gate to it. So by using this particular code, you will be getting all the advantages of the Unacademy Plus. All the added advantages will be directly assigned to you. Secondly, you will directly come to under my guidance and that will surely help you to crack the examination in the least possible time. And you will also get the guidance of the complete team. Okay. And the most important thing is that you will immediately get the 10% discount on that. So immediately you are enabled to get 10% discount once you use this coupon code. So for example, if you talk about the plus subscription, which is costing you 25,000 for 1 year, and if you use this coupon code VishalGate, immediately you are going to get 10% discount, which is 22,500. And if you talk about the Iconic, for the Iconic subscription of the 12 month, this will cost you around 40,400. So these are the cost of the 12 months. And if you want to talk about the 2 year subscription, 2 year subscription cost of the plus, it is your 27,000 after discount. If you want more discount than 10%, if you want more discount than 10% and you have already attended the special classes, then you will be having some credits in your account. Do not forget to use those credits so that you can get more discount than 10%. Now, how can you pay these amounts? So there is one good news for you, that you can pay this amount by using credit cards and debit cards by using the facility of the zero cost EMI. So if you want to pay this particular amount of 22,500 with the help of zero cost EMI, so the zero cost EMI can be availed by using credit cards and debit cards. Remember, you can use the credit card of any company, but the debit card is allowed for HDFC and the Bajaj Finserv. Apart from that, if you want to directly pay this much of amount, you think that this particular amount is the most affordable fees that can be provided to you for 1 year subscription, so aap directly kya kar sakte hain, you can use this credit card, debit card direct payment. You can also go for the EMI options, okay, and you can directly pay this amount by using net banking. Every time you think of the Unacademy Plus subscription, the first thing that should come in your mind is this particular code. Do not forget to use this code once you take the subscription, because I have already told you that this particular coupon code is going to give you a lot of advantages, so you cannot miss the opportunity to use this code. So every student who want to come on to the Unacademy Plus, they want to take the advantages of the Unacademy Plus, they want to empower themselves in the best possible manner in this digital era, they want to be the part of this revolution, then this is the time for you. You do not have to wait for it. If you are in the first year, if you are in the second year, you are in the third year, the best possible time is right now to prepare for the examination, to dedicate yourself, to give yourself the opportunity so that you can get the success as early as possible. Apart from that, you should also join this GATE aspirant group. So this GATE aspirants group is already having 150k plus students, so you can join it. There are a lot of discussions going on between students. You can get the advantage of those discussions. Okay, you can also join this Creatrix channel, which is a Telegram channel. So everyone has to join this channel so that you can get all the PDFs of the lecture which is being assigned to you. Fine, there are various channels which you can go for it. So various channels in the association with Creatrix, so you can follow the channel of your interest. And this is it in today's lecture. So let us meet in the next lecture. Thank you so much.